Hi there, it's Saturday, May 14th, and this is Scott reporting for Cycle Ontario. Today we're going to take a ride down the Kissing Bridge Trailway from Wallenstein to West Montrose.
Okay, I guess it's time to get our little adventure started here. We're just picking up the trail off Side Road 18, just north of 86 in Wallenstein. Sorry about the tick 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 sound, it's the rain falling on the top of the camera. And what would a little tour along an Ontario trail be without patches of our provincial flower, the trillium? Here's a little background on the Kissing Bridge Trailway. The abandoned 45-kilometer stretch of rail line from Guelph to Milbank was purchased by the province in 1990 and subsequently leased by the region in 97 as a rails-to-trails conversion project. You'll notice a large sign just as we get past the gate here, no trespassing on the rifle range, which makes sense to me. And here we are crossing the first of several very nicely constructed bridges going over the creeks along the way. Just coming up on the right here is the scenic 18-hole Elmira Golf Club, nestled in the Eldale Valley. Although Mother Nature wasn't really cooperating, it was really nice to see a few families out on the trail for the SpringontheTrail event. A little more about the Kissing Bridge Trailway. The operations of the trailway are coordinated by a volunteer trailway advisory board. It's representatives of five steward groups consisting of the Elmira Lions Club, the Conestoga Winterburn Optimist Club, the Guelph Hiking Club, the Linwood Lions Club, and the Golden Triangle Snowmobile Club. Just up on the left here past the gate, you'll notice there's a large area where trees have been planted in memory of family and friends. This area is also part of the Trans-Canada Trail system, and there are quite a few plaques along the way that highlight some of the local species of plants and animals. Just up on the left here, we'll see the Elmira Lions Club has set up their fundraising burger stand for the day. And here, just on the other side of Arthur Street in Elmira, is one of the checkpoints for the Spring on the Trail event. The participants can just stop in here, get their passport stamped.
Hi, how are you? Good. I'm trying to be prepared.
Here we are crossing what I'm sure is the busiest road along this stretch of trail we've been traveling. This is Northfield Drive, which runs into Waterloo. Sorry about the giant drops of water on the camera lens here, but Mother Nature was definitely dumping on me along the way. It's kind of funny how these things work out sometimes, but I guess there were a couple of volunteers back at Middlebrook Road who probably got kind of wet and left. We were getting near the end of the day. But anyways, the purpose of them being there was to redirect traffic because apparently where I was headed was going to be a dead end. But as usual, hindsight being 2020, it probably worked out much better this way anyways, because as you can see, this is where the bridge is out, crossing the mighty Conestoga. And as they say, a picture's worth a thousand words, so this is the whole purpose behind Spring on the Trail. They're trying to raise some money to get some suspension bridges to cross these gaps. So anyways, thanks for watching, and be sure to check out Spring on the Trail in 2012, second Saturday in May, and we'll talk to you again soon.